Noi.
Bate omor, bă, că te bat!
De mă face, mă?
A doua dată. Stai un pic.
Hai.
Y'all, Bill the Hall of Fame collector here. No autographs to show in this video. That might be a first for me. However, I will just have in the background there a little bit of Rogers Hornsby. Of course, an excellent Hall of Fame autograph to own. What I do add to this collection is a really good Hall of Fame rookie card. The most expensive one in my collection. Again, I'm fairly new to the rookie card scene, but I'm still kind of unsure of how I feel about it. But anyways, this one actually worked out as a really good deal. Then I got some Maddux cards, of course, towards the end. This stuff here in the background here is essentially the rest of the cards here I have on deck to show in the coming videos. I also have more showcases to kind of just reflect upon what I have. Really good one coming up soon. I just gathered the cards all up and man. Anyways, this card, let me show it. Pick this up, a few months ago. Sandy Koufax, rookie card. Right off the bat, banger there. I know these cards are crazy right now, but that wasn't the case a few months ago. They were starting to shoot up or what have you. I won this on a Probstein auction, and what's good about Probstein is that I'm at like a town or two over, so I've met him before, he knows me, but I walked in with cash, picked it up, so no shipping, no tax paid. That sort of thing. So I walked out with cash, I think I spent $1,000 even. Within 2-3 weeks, it doubled and then tripled in price. And I think at one point it was maybe 3.5 times what I paid. It since has dropped back. I want to say it's still probably at least 2 to 2.5, maybe two. I don't know. Two and a half. I don't even really care, but it's at least still double of what I paid. So, Sandy Koufax rookie. Nice. On to Gregory Maddux. This first one here just shows you how cool, you know, mid to late early 90s into early 2000s the cards were. This one here is from 2000 Upper Deck. It is called Statitude. Very, very easy card to get. You see the gold outline there? It's only 1 in 4 packs and 1 in 120 to get the player you want. However, this one is not as easy. This is a variant. You can notice it's silver instead of the gold or copper, and it is die cut. So these are numbered out of 100. So just an example of some of the cool stuff they did in this era. Next, another pretty cool one. Donruss Elite 2001. They had an insert called Tidal Waves. And Tidal Waves, there were 1,997 cards produced. However, the first 100 were on a foil finish. And this is one of them. And this card is gorgeous. I'm glad I won this. I paid a little bit more than I thought I would have. But again, it's one of those things where you may not know it's rare, but you know it's rare. The people that know, know. So just another reason why, you know, it's really good to get into 90s. You can sometimes score some good deals. This is number 17 of 1997. Again, the first 100 are foil, the hollow foil, and then the rest were the standard foil. And I think I have the regular one. Let's go to 2000 Bowman. This is a parallel. This is the gold parallel. It's kind of a boring card, but it has the gold foil there. It is out of 99, which is actually pretty tough. One in 64 packs, or one in 28,160 to get the player you want. So you had to open a lot of packs. This one can be easily mistaken for the regular card also. This is from 99 Revolution. This is the triple header. So the regular one has this silver here is all gold. And that's the regular one, and it's fairly easy to get. However, this is the silver one, and so they call it the tier. And being so, it is numbered out of 99. So really happy to get that one, for sure. All right, the Tidal Waves here actually went back a few other years. This one is from 1998, Donruss Preferred Tidal Waves. This card actually surprised me, really did. I really like this card in person, and they are dirt cheap. So it's a die-cut card, it has the foil accents, and if this card was out of the, sleeves here, it is super shiny, it's like a plastic card. It's just really nice. If you're just getting into 90s, just pick up one of these. These are really nice, and they are out of Maddox is out of 1995 because of his 1995 World Series champion. I'm assuming other players have different years. All right, this one's a very easy one also. 98 Circa Thunder, limited access. And it is one in 18 packs, or one in 270. What's cool is this actually folds down, it folds up, and it opens to like a huge card. All right, 1998 Leaf, State Representatives. Obviously, Greg Maddux representing, I guess it's Georgia. I don't think it's his hometown. I think he's from Texas, but I guess it's Georgia for the team there. And it is numbered out of 5,000. All right, this card is from second to last here. 1996 SP. This is the marquee matchups. Typically, this card is not die-cut. It's a standard square card. However, this is the die-cut, which is harder to come by. The die-cut was 1 in 61 packs, or 1 in 1,220. And the last card here to show off is from 2001 Fleer Legacy. This is the parallel to the base card. It's the ultimate parallel, and it is out of 250.